are failing to progress. But what this covenant will differ from where it is another position. So we have been failing to identify someone with the potential to do that. Right? We are having problems. Will you be able to do that? Right? So as you as a manager, it's not an element of just saying I will do it and I will bring it. But you have to find out why is it that the company or the organization failed. Discover, find out, go this side, go that side and find out. But tell them, give me time, I have to study the organization first before I ask the question. Because I don't know what has made this organization to meet those problems. So I give you time. You may discover that maybe the resources that they were using were outdated resources. You may discover that they were insufficient resources, right? It's where now your knowledge of capability should come in now. It's better now you have to think of resources. So you can now start drawing this issue on what? Capability. You have to bring in. In other words, capability, you can look at resource based now. And maybe resource based, you are looking at my resources which are very unique. And not only unique, but sometimes when you bring in resources, you know, the input here, the resources there, can be of low quality. Can be, you can have resources which are very, they can be very cheap resources here. Very cheap resources. The quality can be low quantity, the quantity can be low quantity. But after that is coming out of that one should be very nice, something which is very desirable. People would like that. That's the one we have to think of. Therefore, we are looking at the criteria for a person of strategic ability. Now, one of the elements here, we are looking at in terms of complexity, culture, this one here. And a bit of casual ability. What do you mean? Sometimes you are in an organization and you want resources that are very unique. Firstly, you need to study how complex are those items. Are they different complex? So when you have this complexity, is where now you have to think of internal now. You can link them internally and how you can link them externally so that you are outsourcing business resources. They come. Another issue is about cultural history of those resources. You need to find out. You are in an organization. You have to find out the culture and the history of resources that they have been using. What's the culture like? And that's the organization. If that is the case, then why can't you think of the history? What have they been doing from the past? And from the human being culture and history, now it is taking you from the taking from the private activity and back to dependence now. They are taking you from taken for granted activity. Taken for granted activity. Activity. And I have to say that it's part of dependency. Part of dependency. Culture. Sometimes the culture is a problem. Sometimes the historical background of what you have been outsourcing is a problem. What you most of the time you take things for granted. That's why you take it for granted activities. There are other activities you just take them casually because you know your organization that you are in, whether they study like government or education culture. So you use that matter, this is not the can you check from your as we are saying, can you check from your the party dependence, the meaning of party dependence from your party dependence? Oh, yeah. Check from your next, what is the meaning of party dependence?
If most times this robust is coming in because of one of the activities just goes
people have been using these scripts from the past and they are just reading. You just adopted using it for our achieve. You don't want to change. That's what it's called positive. There is no change. You use it continuously. One of the products that you know that people have been using it because you are just copying it, you are just using it because of historical background. We are talking about different children, you are just using it after the game. Which product is that? What is an example of a product? You are using it, your grandfather used it, and you are using it because they used it, and then you are just using it after the game. Which product is that?
Where you are looking at yourself. The only solution, what as a manager, what you have to
Why can't you leave the activities? How do you leave the activities? How many times are complex, you can leave the activities. How do you leave them? It's where our innovation is coming in. Flexibility is coming in. It's this one. You need to be very flexible. Flexibility, you need to be innovative. You have to see how innovation is there. Innovation and flexibility are not exactly the same complex in your organization. You need to be very complex. Why? Because you are trying to do innovation and flexibility, right? For that. Right? In other words, you need to have external interconnected of competencies. Where you think that is very difficult, why can't you indicate? No, you have to have. If sometimes what you need to imitate, you need to come up with this specialization where to use that. But in terms of historical, not to ever this one, this cultural history, the issue of party dependence is coming in. Party dependence. Where you have to leave culture, to leave everything for your organization and then pass it by and by. So, we have that where we will get party dependency. But in terms of cultural ambiguity, again, it's another area that we have to talk about. The end behind is coming up with what I call dynamic ability. Where we are looking at is what is called dynamic. Let me define what are dynamic capabilities by definition. Definition of dynamic capabilities. Dynamic capabilities by definition, there are those organizational abilities to be able to change. So, organizations develop change competences. There are those organizations that can develop change competences. So they have to develop change competences. So meet the needs of the empowered people, meet the needs of the change environment. Meeting the needs of the change environment. Meeting the need of changing environment. Love to change. Every task for change. Change. Right? You go, in other words, what you go by, you go by model. You go by the model or add that particular type. You go by the model of that particular type. Other people. So, there are several things that sometimes people are saying to change business capabilities. It can be because of what? Money, what? Fashion, and sometimes, there are other. I'm not going to tell you that you can't change. But people are saying, as a junior, I think you can't go by that change. So, there are those things that are the ones that you they hit that dynamic capability. In other words, my sources they have to change. We have to go by change. That's why here when we talk about dynamic capability, you can explain something about the introduction of IT. Information technology, it is bringing things to change. Resources have to change. They are changing from manual to automation. Changing from manual to automated. That's the dynamic capability. Resources. Current and car, when they wanted to pump a pound then, they use the manual of pound then, which you cannot use. Then go on again. That's that issue. I don't know that. you have to change your office by resources due to being of the need of the environment. So, right? That is used to be used to do that. I want to do about to do that and both about that.
They have to change, and then they have to lead you to what is called organization knowledge. We talk about
shared experiences. So we are moving from dynamic capabilities, things that are changing, that because things are changing, they have to develop what is called organizational knowledge. You are there, actually, you are the manager of the company. And then from the manager of the company, then you are told to change the organization from where it is. So you think of this dynamic capability and resources. Then another answer that you have to think of is what is called organization knowledge. So let's define what is this organization knowledge. Organization knowledge is defined as the collective and shared experiences. This is the collective and shared experiences. That is accumulation from the systems. In other words, they are built from the organization system. Accumulated from organization system. And activities across the organization. So knowledge is defined as awareness, or is defined as a collective and shared experience. That you have made from systems, routine, and activities of that organization. The organizational knowledge, you need to have a knowledge of the organization. Collecting and sharing experiences. That's why this issue of organizational knowledge, in an organization, you have what is called the human resource, you have the human capital. You have what is called human capital, HC. The human capital. So the human capital, in other words, you are looking at the human resource, HR, is part of the individuals that are working in the organization. And the fact that they are there, dynamic is coming in because things are changing. You have to accommodate each and everyone's view of the organization. Everyone has to add what he or she knows in that organization. You have to accommodate experiences. Accommodate each one of their views. Take them to touch. Implement them. That's what's called organization knowledge. A very good manager will be able to have what's called organization knowledge. Should be able to take each one of these guys' views. That's why dynamic capability is coming in. That things are changing. No man is an island. You need to have to support each other. You have to support each other in your organization. Hey, there's a need for you to what is known as division of labor here. Division of labor comes here. Division of labor in an organization. Simply asking, well, we have an organization and I'll be the general manager myself, I'll be the supervisor myself, I'm taking again the responsibility of finance controller, in your small bank manager, or the finance controller is myself. That's not all. These guys, they have to report, giving them responsibility, and the fact that they are the general manager, they have to report it to you. They have to report it to you. That they are reporting it to our boss. Yeah, boss has been done. That's the reason they are never going to have to do the organization. Okay? So you have to be proud that, you know, you are there. Whoever is that you acquire from the organization. What is this organization? Any organization has this system, has this culture. The way it has been moving from one point to another, that's why it's called the system. If a part of the system is blocked, the whole organization is dead. That's why it's falling like that, just as a train. You know what a train is? When a train is moving, when a train is moving through its rail, and if one of the bogs is detached, or one of the former, what do you call it, it's not functioning well, or if it has collapsed, it means the whole train again is affected. That's why we are saying it's more like the chain of a bicycle, where each and every part is linked. If one of the chain is broken, then it means it is separating the other parts from the other. That's why in an organization, you have to wait as a unifying whole. If you know that one of the chain is not functioning well, take it out and then make the other part so that it is moving well. If you find it in an organization, one is behaving, approach that crop and then plant another crop, replace it that one. You find your organization is working. That's why we're looking at it as organization knowledge. You need to have this knowledge in your, so that this knowledge is there to make sure that whichever, because they'll be able to use all the physical resources, they'll be able to, the experience will be able to be shared amongst yourself. I'm looking at that. How to exchange knowledge, share knowledge and experiences, that's what is called community of interest, trust, social contact and trust. You have to trust each other, and at the same time, right, you have to take money from all angles. That is about. I think for today, if we stop there, I think it's the I didn't mean that you had the photocopy of working here. Sometimes I was just photocopied it. But the school has not used this book. I use this book first in the book. It's probably corporate strategy. We don't have this book, but.
Value nature, and then that is the value nature.
in order that I want to be a bottom, what I am a bottom, but what I
am a bottom.
That is the father of you. Kind of good in our hand.
You don't know when you are going to do this.
And that is the feeling, that is the only. If you are called to the organization, you are never. The issue is not the 50%. The issue is, can you be able to deliver? Assuming you are given an organization, can you be able to take the organization from where it is to another level? That is the most important thing here. Right?
Yeah.
Organization is not one level, but family again is an organization. Family is an organization because you have got cash in the family. Family is an organization. You'll be going to family, that's your organization. Will you be able to take your organization to the family to another level? Or you are going to make the family going down? That was an organization. That's all I look at in this. Bring it up with you. Museum of Policy was not an organization. Ah, I'm not going to be that. I'm not going to be that.